at the start of the pandemic, many people weren't getting treated for other emergencies because they were actually afraid they'd be exposed to COVID-19 in the emergency room.
Well, now things are changing. Hospitals are seeing an increase of patients. Joining us now is Dr. Joseph Chan, Medical Director of Emergency Services over at Beverly Hospital in Montebello.
Thank you.
The status of emergency rooms right now.
So we are definitely seeing a trend in increase in our volumes as compared to May or June, although I would say that we are still below what our typical summer volumes would be. So we do have capacity.
And Dr. Chan, what policies are ERs adopting right now to keep non-COVID-19 patients safe from infection?
Mm-hmm. Well, to start off with, most hospitals are all screening patients, so anyone that is coming in with potential symptoms of viral infections such as fever, cough, or difficulty breathing are separated. At our hospital in particular, if patients are well enough to be able to sit in a chair throughout most of their visit, we have a completely separate treatment area for them outdoors where they can be waiting 6 feet apart and with masks on, but still have full capabilities to do labs, EKGs, and chest x-rays, or even breathing treatments all in an open, well-ventilated space that's also shaded. If they are sick enough that they need to come inside for more intensive care, then we keep them separated from other patients by putting them into rooms where they have closed doors, negative air pressure, so they can be kept isolated from other patients inside. In addition, to also keep patients safe, we also have to keep the staff safe. So all the staff has their temperature screened every morning. We wear eye protection and mask at all times when we're around patients so that we can protect our staff from inadvertently passing on to other people.
And doctor, can you give us an idea? Let's say you're home, you're not feeling well. How should people make the decision about what is an emergency and what is not?
It's a tricky question because medical emergencies can literally affect any part of the body. And sometimes the initial symptoms can be very nonspecific and vague. So things like acute appendicitis, strokes, and heart attacks. Some of them, their initial symptoms may be very mild. But the things that I would summarize that generally would indicate that something is time sensitive and may require an urgent intervention include things like significant abdominal pain, any chest pain really, any subtle neurologic symptoms like numbness, weakness, vision changes, confusion, and then obviously difficulty breathing. If you're not sure and you're feeling relatively well and you're concerned about going in, obviously one of the options is you can try to call your primary care doctor. And for those that don't have one, there's a lot of other available telehealth options out there that they can help you figure out whether you should go in person and seek emergency care.
Mm-hmm. And Dr. Chan, with the spike in cases recently, has anything changed in the ER since the beginning of the pandemic?
A lot of things have changed. I think one of the issues is that the testing, I think there's a lot more awareness out there. We're seeing a lot more patients arrive asking to be evaluated and tested in the ERs. I think LA County had rapidly expanded its testing, but even that has its limits. One of the things that we used to refer patients to if they weren't that sick was to try to get tested through LA County because there are plenty of appointments. And now we're seeing that there are long lines and none of the appointment slots available for the next 2 to 3 days. So we're seeing long waits for those as well. There was a lot of very severe PPE shortages in the beginning of the pandemic. And I think that we're seeing some improvements in there. I wouldn't say that everybody has the ability to get all of their orders, their back orders filled. But we're definitely in a better place than we were at the beginning of the pandemic.
All right, Dr. Chan, thank you so much for joining us this afternoon. Of course, good luck to you and your staff. Not an easy job to have these days, so we thank you for being with us.
Thank you, Dr. Chan.